I'm here with Brendan Lehman. Talk to us a little about your fight coming up on Saturday.
I'm ready. Today, 23-0. Come Saturday night, 24-0.
And you're fighting an opponent in Juan. You've been around the block a couple of times. How did you prepare to fight almost a veteran again now?
We prepared by going a whole lot of rounds, knowing that he's a good boxer. We brought in some boxing style type of dudes, knowing that Juan's a boxer. And if I got to go 10 rounds, I'm ready.
And I'm going to ask you on stage, do you think 2022 will be a campaign year for a world title? What's some of the names you want that's coming out there in 2022?
I hope so, because I'll be 23 by then. By the end of 2022, I'll be 23 and a half. So I think I'll have my full man's runs rate. If not, at least 75% of it. And line them up. Anybody.
I know his last opponent was Regis Progress. I talked to Regis last week. He said nobody in the 140 division want to fight him. Would you be up to fight a Regis Progress fight?
Man, to be honest, I don't think Progress can make 140, so he got to rethink that.
And the titles at 140 seem like they're all, entangled with Josh Taylor.
Yeah.
How do you see his fight coming out in February? And if he stays at 140, would you be up for Josh Taylor fight?
The dude that Josh Taylor's fighting, I really don't know. I don't know him that much. So, I'm going to just rock with Josh Taylor just from seeing his style. He's a good boxer, southpaw. He's a smart fighter. He can bang as well. And, hell yeah, if I got a chance to become undisputed, why not?
The last time you fought at StubHub, you had a crazy crowd turn out for you. Do you expect the same crowd? Do you still get nervous fighting since you're from Southern California? And the crowd comes to see you?
I'm not expecting the same crowd. I'm expecting a bigger crowd this time.
Ah.
There should be a good amount of people, coming out to support. So I'm super grateful for that. And 24-0 coming this Saturday.
Thank you so much, bro.